Hello everyone, my name is Ashutosh Bahuguna. I'm working as a scientist with the Indian Computer Emergency Response Team. In this session, we will discuss about the cybersecurity incident handling and role of the Indian Computer Emergency Response Team. In this session, we are going to discuss about the cybersecurity initiatives in India. So, as you may be aware about the Digital India program launched by the Government of India, that program is have centered on the three key visions, that is the digital infrastructure as a utility to every citizen, governance and services on demand, and digital empowerment of citizens. Cybersecurity and data privacy issues are crucial for success and operation of the program's function launched under Digital India. It's the cybersecurity and the privacy are the very, very important part to make that program Digital India the successful. Various initiatives are launched by Indian Computer Emergency Response Team to counter the cyber threats. If we look at the cybersecurity, there is a dynamic landscape. So threats are evolving and changing how they hit the target. So, if we see that dynamic landscape, there is an expanding role and implementation of technology across sectors in the country, including the critical sectors like health, energy, water, oil and gas, and others. Volume and complexity of information technology ecosystem in the country. So, that's increasing volume and complexity. Growth in volume of transactions and sensitive data exchange. There is a growth in volume of transaction, including the financial transaction, and the sensitive data is exchanged in the transactions. There is a rapidly changing security and threat landscape. The new type of threats are emerging on a daily basis. There is a paradigm shift in attack vectors and nature of their launch. So how the attackers are targeting, that is also changing. Reduce cybersecurity risk exposure of IT infrastructure and ecosystem in the country. Responsibility to ensure proper process, technology, governance, structure and compliance to laws and regulatory requirements. So this is the responsibility to ensure the proper processes, technology, governance, structure and compliance to law and regulatory requirements. So one of the initiatives is the National Cybersecurity Policy by Government of India, Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology. So, what is the need of National Cybersecurity Policy? So, the need is to facilitate creation of secure computing environment and enabling advocate trust and confidence in electronic transactions. How that trust and confidence will come in the electronic transaction is by securing it. Guide stakeholders' actions with the various parties operating in that ecosystem for protection of cyberspace. That policy will provide that guidance. Outline a roadmap to create a framework for comprehensive, collaborative, and collective response to issues in cybersecurity. That will provide a roadmap to create a framework that will help us to collective response against the cyber threats. Adopt appropriate strategy both at national and international level. So, cyberspace is not having any fixed boundaries, so we need to have appropriate strategies at a national and international level to counter the cyber threats. So, National Cybersecurity Policy articulate our concerns, what are our concerns are, understanding, priorities for action as well as directed efforts. It provide confidence and reasonable assurance to all stakeholders in the country, government, businesses, industry and general public, and global community about the safety, resilience and security of cyberspace. Adopt a suitable posturing that can signal our resolve to make determined efforts to effectively monitor, deter and deal with cybercrime and cyber attacks. And policy implementation by means of some actions by the government only, some action in the collaborative PPP mode, some actions by the private enterprises and the academia. So, this National Cybersecurity Policy is available at the website of Ministry of Electronics and IT, and this is the national level guiding document in the domain of cybersecurity. We have the Cyber Crisis Management Plan at a national level to ensure that manipulation of critical function services in critical sector organization are brief, infrequent and manageable and cause least possible damage. So this plan help us to react to the cyber crisis, cyber incident and to build our cyber resiliency. The plan also help ministries, departments to draw up their own contingency plan in case of a cyber attack or a cyber threat. To assist organization to put in place, this plan also assists organization to put in place mechanism to effectively deal with the cyber security crisis situation. In India, we have an Information Technology Act 2000 and Amendment 2008 and rules. This is a law in India dealing with cyber crime and electronic commerce. The act also aims to provide legal framework so that legal stand is accorded to all electronic records like a digital signature. The act states that unless otherwise agreed, an acceptance of contract may be expressed by electronic means of communication and shall have legal validity and enforceability. IT Act includes regulation of certifying authorities, legal recognition of digital signature, functions of Indian Computer Emergency Response Team, and cybercrime penalties and punishments. So the details and the act is available at the meti.gov.in. Under Section 70B of Indian Information Technology Act, the CERTIN, designated CERTIN as the national nodal agency to serve as a national agency to perform the following function in area of cybersecurity. So collection, analysis and dissemination of information on cyber incidents, forecast and alerts of cybersecurity incidents, emergency measures for handling cybersecurity incident, coordination of cyber incident response activities, issue guidelines, advisory, vulnerability notes, and white papers relating to information security practices, procedures, prevention, response, and reporting of cyber incidents, and the other functions related to the cyber security. So these are the roles and responsibilities of the CERTIN defined under the Section 70B of the Information Technology Act. So CERTIN is the basically national nodal agency to respond to the cyber threats. So type of a cyber security incidents, what we are observing in the wild is the web defacement, web intrusion and propagation of malicious program in a software, malicious code, is in botnets, crimeware, rogue antivirus, data theft and data manipulation attack like identity theft, financial fraud, scanning and probing the targets, denial of service attack and distributed denial of service attack like flooding, social engineering scams, spam and targeted attacks, especially on the government and critical sector organizations. Security cooperation and collaborations improved to respond to the cybersecurity incidents. So at an international level, the member of the Forum for Incident Response Team, the member of Asia-Pacific CERT, research partner with Anti-Phishing Working Group, cooperation with product and security vendors, all IT vendors operating in the country, collaborative efforts, sectoral CERT, CISO of critical sectors, ISPs, industry association in IT and non-IT areas. So this cooperation and collaboration is very crucial for responding to the cyber security incidents and to build a cyber resiliency. Another initiative of CERTIN is the empanelment process. In the empanelment process, the information security auditing organization, the organization, the firm, the organization who are conducting the assessment, vulnerability assessment, compliance audit, penetration testing, have to go through the series of tests at CERTIN to be qualified as an empaneled organization. So this is the four round process, starting with the documentation round in which the organization have to submit their document for verification and proving their skill sets. Then there is an offline take-home test in which the organization are provided with the virtual vulnerable setups. They have to identify the vulnerabilities and clear that test. After that, there is a black box test in which the organization again have to perform vulnerability assessment of the provided target and complete some challenges, like in a capture the flag. And if they are able to qualify that, then there is an interaction session with them where they have to defend their reports and prove their capability. After that, they are impaneled by certain, and that list of the impaneled organization is a dynamic in nature. That means there is a continuous review of their capabilities, and if they are not found fit, they are dropped from the impaneled list. Remote profiling is conducted by certain. It's a kind of a red team activity, red team exercise on the target network. So, especially critical and government information infrastructure, the CERTIN is conducting the assessment remotely, remote assessment of the security posture. The cyber security exercises, we will be discussing this in the detail, but the cyber security exercises is a kind of a simulated crisis, simulated incidents where organization learn from those incidents, simulated incidents, and their preparedness can be assessed and their posture can be improved. CERTIN, this is website of the Indian Computer Emergency Response Team. There are a virus alert, advisories, and sort of a information related to the cyber security which can be used by the organization to improve their cyber security posture and maintain the situational awareness. Here you can see there is a virus alert of Serve Helper malware. It's published in January 2019, and it's this malware is a backdoor. There is a cyber threat intelligence hunting and sharing. So, proactively looking for the threat information, threat intelligence from the internal sources, what the CERT is analyzing, and from the external feeds, and then we are generating the indicators of a compromise, and that are shared with the organizations so that their devices, those organizations, are better prepared to counter the cyber attack. Honeypots and sensor are deployed at a different level to collect the attacker methodology, attack vectors, and motives of attackers. So there are basically two types of the honeypots, the research honeypot and production honeypot. So a research honeypot is used to study about the tactics and techniques of attacker. It is used as a monitor to observe how an attacker is compromising a system. In production, honeypot is used for detection and to protect organization by acting as a decoy system. So that honeypot will act as a decoy system, and the attackers are redirected to that, or lured to that, waste basically their time there and protect the organization's main and critical assets. CI, so Chief Information Security Officer, guidelines are also released by Ministry of Electronics and IT, and the key responsibilities and roles are defined there to help the Chief Information Security Officer to design their cyber security plan within our organization. If you go through some of the roles and responsibility, it's maintaining and updating the threat landscape for the organization on a regular basis. So basically, CISO is responsible for maintaining the situational awareness, what type of threats, what type of cyber incidents are happening, and what can impact their organization. Establishing a security program and business continuity program, and drafting the various security policy, like a acceptable use policy or the user policies. Those policies need to be developed by the CISO, and they have to implement a cyber security program, preferably using some standard or a framework. Ensuring review of the information security policy by internal or external subject matter experts that need to be reviewed. Establishing and reviewing the risk assessment methodology, how the risk assessment is done for the organization, and selection of appropriate control for risk mitigation. And then there need to selection of a controls so that risk can be mitigated. Interacting with the regulatory bodies is a point of contact from organization to interact with the external agencies, such as the Indian Computer Emergency Response Team. CISO is responsible for the log, alert analysis, and exception reporting, vulnerability assessment and penetration testing, web application security assessments, ensure that software development lifecycle audit and periodic code reviews are done, should ensure there is no unsupported operating systems, prescribed hardening guidelines, patch management guidelines, antivirus malware guidelines, no privilege access on endpoints, regular review of access privileges, acceptance configuration guidelines, and procedures are properly implemented. These things need to be ensured by the CISO. Citizen customer data privacy to be ensured in case if citizen customer data is captured and maintained. This is very critical from the privacy point of view. Incident response plan. In case of some alert, some abnormal behavior or incident happened to the organization, then there must be incident response plan to deal with cyber crisis, contingency and disaster attack on the IT systems. In India, we are seeing the surge in the digital payments, and for that there are these initiatives and guidelines are there for the secure digital payments, like a secure mobile banking. 0071-0070, these are the guidelines for mobile banking. How to securely do the mobile banking? These are the guidelines and advisory from the CERT. Safeguarding smartphones against cyber attacks, this can be seen in the CERT advisory. There is a RBI notification on security and risk mitigation measures. Technical audit of prepared payment instrument issuer. So this is RBI notification. So how to consider in the technical audit. Awareness programs are conducted by Government of India, and cyber security frameworks and guidelines are also issued that are available at the Ministry of Electronics and IT website and certain website, which can be used by your organization to improve their cyber security preparedness. Some of the things like cyber security baseline controls, which is having a 5 basic security controls, CIS 20 critical security controls, are recommended for the organization to implement at their end to start with cyber security program. And then they have to move to the new cyber security framework and implementation of ISMS, that is the information security management system. So if you see at the 5 controls, basic security controls, we start with the inventory of devices and software that need to be maintained by your organization. The administrative privileges should be controlled. It should not be distributed to all. The organization should have the secure configuration template for hardware and the software, should have in place malware defense, anti-malware solutions, and the vulnerability and patch management. If there is any vulnerability that need to be detected, and it should be patched. Similarly, the CIS 20 critical controls we will discuss in the details is there, which can be the starting point for the organization. So these are the recommended practices to the organization to improve the cyber security. Training and awareness programs are there. There are technical trainings and workshop provided by CERT also. The details are available at the website. There is an information security education and awareness program by Ministry of Electronics and IT, that is the building awareness and training human resources who could take up research and development, develop indigenous solutions, software, secure and maintain various systems, including critical infrastructure, are key objective of this project. So, in this session, we have discussed about the process of incident handling. We have seen the various frameworks like a cyber kill chain and mid-tray attack framework, which can be used by the incident handlers. We have discussed the role of Indian Computer Emergency Response Team, which is a national nodal agency to respond to the cyber security incident. Thank you.